today, welcome again to Chief Boyet, and today I'll be sharing you about the Yanmar ECR.
If you want to learn about Yanmar ECR, selective catalytic reduction, then this video is for you. The Yanmar ECR technology comply with IMO Tier 3 regulation. Just like what I have shared in one of my video about managing ECR, the Yanmar diesel generator ECR is also part of NOx Tier 3 technologies to reduce the emission of NOx into atmosphere. The reason why many ship owners choosing ECR is because the NOx reduction level is very high and it has only few influence to engine performance. So let's have a short review about the Tier 3 regulation or NOx Tier 3 regulation. This regulation for regulating exhaust gas from ships came into effect on January 1, 2016. This regulation requires 80% reduction in NOx or nitrogen oxide emission compared to Tier 1 regulation. On January 1, 2016, this regulation applied only to the cost of US and Canada. But on January 1, 2021, North Sea and Baltic Sea also became designated area. But before getting into the operation, let's first have a look at the outline of Yanmar ECR. Yanmar ECR is composed of catalyst reactor, the nozzle, pump unit, the air treatment unit, the temperature and humidity sensor, the changeover valve or exhaust gas changeover valve, the urea injection nozzle, and the control panel. For the catalyst reactor, inside the reactor casing, it has a two layers of catalyst where the NOx and ammonia or NH2 reacts to change into harmless nitrogen and water. Nozzle unit, this unit controls urea water amount and assists airflow for supply to urea water injection nozzle. Urea injection nozzle, this is where the urea water and air are supplied from the nozzle unit. The pump unit, it is a circulation pump that keeps the urea water at a constant pressure and circulates. This air treatment unit, it purifies air which is used for ECR and called as assist air. Just like what I mentioned, the urea water and assist air is being injected together through the urea injection nozzle. Exhaust gas changeover valve. This valve switches the exhaust gas passage to catalyst side or to bypass side. When ECR is running, the changeover valve to catalyst side is open and a valve for bypass passage is closed. The temperature and humidity sensor, this sends the engine room temperature and humidity. The amount of NOx emitted from the engine is highly dependent in the atmospheric condition before the combustion, and it is not constant. The purpose of this sensor is to accurately predict the ever-changing amount of NOx at the engine. And lastly is the control panel. The ECR control panel continuously monitors the engine and ECR system status with all functions performed automatically based on operating condition. This makes operation easier for the user. Okay, so let's proceed with the ECR principle. How does it reduces NOx? The ECR system is a device that reduces the NOx by chemical reaction on the ECR catalyst. And the ECR uses urea as reducing agent. The urea water solution is being injected into exhaust gas inside the mixing pipe. The water evaporates and thermally decomposes or vaporizes. Using the heat of exhaust gas and the hydrolysis of urea, this converts or generates ammonia, then will mix to the exhaust gas before reaching the ECR catalyst. On the catalyst, the NOx and the generated ammonia reacts or through the chemical reaction, it breaks down into harmless nitrogen or N2 and water or H2O. Therefore, after the reactor, the NOx of the exhaust gas from the engine has reduced about 80% or more compared to tier 1. But if the amount of ammonia supplied is insufficient for the NOx in the exhaust gas, the NOx leaves the ECR catalyst untreated. So, meaning the emitted exhaust gas is still containing of high percentage of NOx. So In this case, this is a failure to comply the emission regulation. After knowing the principle, let's proceed to the operation. If you will be starting the ECR, first you have to line up all the bulbs. Please refer to the operating procedure, what are those bulbs needs to open. So after this preparation, change over the engine consumption from high sulfur to MGO or LSMGO with a sulfur content of 0.1 and below at 2 hours before entering the alkaline. It is also necessary to input the concentration of urea water in the control panel. In general, 40% urea water is used for marine ECR. After changing over the fuel, turn on the ECR in the control panel. Then the catalyst warm-up operation is required for about 2 hours before starting the operation of ECR. It is also recommended to run the catalyst warm-up operation at engine load of about 50% or higher. And the injection automatically starts when the engine in ECR system condition meets or become the following condition. First is when the engine load rate is 22.5% or more. When the exhaust gas temperature reaches 270 degrees Celsius or higher at the reactor inlet, and 250 degrees Celsius or higher at the reactor outlet. When the circulation pump for the urea water is operating and circulation pressure is 0.65 MPa or more. Fourth, when the assist air supply pressure is 0.4 MPa or more. And PF is when the exhaust gas passage has changed to catalyst line. And six, when the system shutdown alarm is not activated. Then, the urea injection automatically starts. The catalyst reactor is fitted with a soot blower. This is to prevent the soot accumulation and catalyst deterioration. High pressure air is injected to blow off the soot in the catalyst while ECR is running, and the soot blowing is every 30 minutes or once every 30 minutes. In ECR, there is a relationship between fuel sulfur concentration and exhaust gas temperature, where acidic ammonium sulfate precipitation occurs. It normally melts at higher temperature. And this ammonium sulfate look like crystal, clogs the catalyst and lowered the NOx reduction rate. Therefore, it is necessary to keep the exhaust gas at appropriate temperature at ECR inlet or reactor inlet. After knowing the starting and running operation of ECR, so let's proceed on how to stop the ECR operation. First, just simply turn off the ECR at control panel before changing over the fuel oil. Then, after turning off, switch the fuel oil at engine from MGO to high sulfur FO. When ECR has turned off, the control panel automatically changes the exhaust gas changeover valve from the catalyst line to the bypass line. It also automatically stops the injection and circulation of the urea water. After the injection stops, the urea water remaining in the nozzle unit and urea injection nozzle is purged to the drain tank about 5 minutes. Then, you have to close all the valves that you have opened before starting the operation. And that's all. You already stopped the ECR operation. If you like this video, kindly hit the like button and share. And if you have some questions, just leave your comment at the comment section below. Again, thank you for watching. God bless us all.
Yanmar. Kasama ko ang pogi-pogi. Sa video katabi sa'yo.